uncovering a relic galaxy in our own cosmic backyard, preparing for launch to the space station, and honoring the legacy of Stephen Hawking. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. Our Hubble Space Telescope has uncovered an ancient relic galaxy in our own cosmic backyard, composed exclusively of aging stars born about 10 billion years ago. The galaxy NGC 1277 has twice as many stars as our Milky Way, but is only one quarter the size. The finding could provide new insights into the origin and evolution of galaxies billions of years ago. Our astronauts Drew Feustel and Ricky Arnold joined Russia's Oleg Artemyev in Kazakhstan to prepare for their upcoming launch to the International Space Station. The Expedition 55-56 trio is set to launch on March 21st for a five-month mission on the orbital outpost. Our Planetary Defense Coordination Office hosted a workshop to show meteorologists how we find, track, and potentially mitigate any future asteroid impact threats to Earth. The office is responsible for issuing timely warnings and communications about potential impacts and leading the coordination of U.S. government planning for a response to an actual impact threat. We helped space fans celebrate Pi Day on March 14th with the 5th annual Pi in the Sky Challenge. Pi is the mathematical constant that starts with the numbers 3.14. The challenge's math problems show how Pi can be used to learn about all kinds of curious features of the universe, including earthquakes on Mars, helium rain on Jupiter, and planets orbiting other stars. Renowned astrophysicist Stephen Hawking died at his home in Cambridge, England on March 14th. In a statement, Acting NASA Administrator Robert Lightfoot called Hawking a longtime friend to NASA and a passionate communicator who wanted to share the excitement of discovery with all. Lightfoot further noted that Hawking's breakthroughs in physics and astronomy changed how we view the cosmos and will continue to play a pivotal role in shaping our efforts to explore our solar system and beyond. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.